Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Deep Biology. In this tutorial, we will be learning about Klinefelter syndrome, which is an important chromosomal abnormality in male. As you know that humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Among these, 22 pairs are autosome and one pair is sex chromosomes. We have denoted female sex chromosome as XX and male X chromosome with XY. Male with Klinefelter syndrome have one extra copy of the X chromosome in the cell. This is a karyotype of male having Klinefelter syndrome, where one extra X copy of chromosome is present instead of single X and Y. Here in position 23 chromosome number, one additional X chromosome is present. Here you can see one additional X chromosome is present. And sometimes male with Klinefelter syndromes have two or three extra X chromosomes. At that case, total number of chromosomes comes at 48 when two extra X chromosomes, and total chromosome number comes 49 when three extra chromosomes or extra copies of both of X and Y are also observed in case of Klinefelter syndromes. Here you can see when one X and Y extra X chromosome present, there the chromosome number comes 48. Here one extra X and one extra Y are present. Frequency of these Klinefelter syndromes, babies is 1 in 500 live male babies. It is seen that in India, less than 1 million cases per year. It is also observed that women who get pregnant after age 35 are slightly more likely to have a boy with this syndrome than younger women. Actually, this one extra X chromosomes are coming at position number 23 because of non-disjunctions at meiosis 1 and meiosis 2 during gametogenesis. The Klinefelter male shows some common symptoms in their body, like they have subfertile with small testes, they have developed breasts, they have delayed puberty and also feminine pitch voice, they have long limbs in compared to normal male, and they also have broader hips, resembling talkativeness. They have sparse body hair. They show mental retardations. They have small penis and low sperm productions. And sometimes they have experienced osteoporosis. Here you can see narrow shoulder are also most notable common symptoms. Short trunks and smaller testicles, I already said, and longer limbs and large breasts. In normal case, in male, small breasts are present. Poor muscle development and sparse facial hair. These are the common symptoms in case of Klinefelter male. This is a schematic representation of gametogenesis process. As we know, gametogenesis are two types. One is oogenesis and other one is spermatogenesis. Oogenesis occur in female ovaries and spermatogenesis occur in male testes. During oogenesis, from primordial germ cells to primary oocytes developments, at this stage primary oocytes having twice the number of chromosomes. At meiosis stage, when primary oocytes develop to secondary oocytes, one polar or fast polar body is produced due to abnormal cytogenesis. In polar body, they receive almost none of cytoplasms and ultimately it became dye, and other cell receives maximum cytoplasm, and this is actually a future mature ovum and ready to part in the process of fertilization. On the other hand, during the process of spermatogenesis, primary oocytes having twice the number of chromosomes, and in the first meiosis step, it produces two cells having n number of chromosomes and produce secondary spermatocytes, and these secondary spermatocytes further divided to spermatids having n number of chromosomes and ultimately produce a active sperms, and then the sperm are also ready for fertilization. The fertilization process are actually being occurred in female body. When ovum are get fertilized with the sperms, both have n number of chromosomes and produced twice n number of zygote. These are the future embryo, and through the process of differentiation became a target animal. This is the whole schematic representation of the gametogenesis process in normal conditions. Here, how male Klinefelter syndromes are produced through the process of non-disjunction at gametogenesis level are discussed. The non-disjunction process are occurred in three levels. In first level is paternal non-disjunction at meiosis 1, second one is maternal non-disjunction at meiosis 2, and third one is maternal non-disjunction at meiosis 3. In first case, paternal non-disjunction set meiosis 1, primary spermatocyte saving twice the number of chromosomes XY at meiosis 1 due to non-disjunctions at these points produce secondary spermatocytes having one XY chromosomes and other cell have none of chromosomes, and ultimately it produces non-fertile sperms. And other both receives XY chromosomes through the process of meiosis 2 or mitosis produce two cells having n number of chromosomes. And when this n number of XY, when this n haploid number of XY chromosome are attached with a normal ovum having n number of X, produce XXY zygotes. So this is a diploid one, where one extra X copy of chromosome presence. Ultimately, in this way, Klinefelter may produce. In second step or second process, when maternal non-disjunctions occur at meiosis 1, at that case, primary oocytes having twice the number of XX chromosomes, and due to non-disjunctions at meiosis 1, it produces two cells, one secondary oocytes and other one is first polar body. First polar body receives none of chromosomes, while secondary oocyte receives two X chromosomes with ample of cytoplasms. And in the next steps, these secondary oocytes produce two cells, one ovum having haploid number of XX chromosomes and second polar body having XX haploid chromosomes but without any cytoplasmic contents and ultimately die. After that, ovum having n number of XX chromosomes receives sperms and involved in the process of fertilizations and produce zygote of twice n numbers with XXY chromosomes. In this case also one additional XX chromosomes come in pictures and ultimately produce Klinefelter situation. The last or third process, when maternal non-disjunctions at meiosis 2, primary oocytes having twice n number of X chromosomes and at meiosis 1 levels and ultimately produce secondary oocytes having haploid number of X chromosomes and one first polar body having haploid number of X chromosome but devoid of cytoplasm and ultimately this first polar body are also die. While secondary oocyte having haploid number of single X chromosomes at this point at the stage of meiosis 2 due to non-disjunction, this secondary oocyte produce one ovum having haploid number of XX chromosomes and produce one second polar body having none of chromosomes. And this haploid number of XX chromosomes take place in the process of fertilization when it's attached with an haploid number of Y sperms and gives rise to produce zygotes having twice the number of XXY chromosome. In this case also, one extra copy of X come in the picture. In this way, male placenta are produced. This is the three steps how a male became Klinefelter. One process is paternal non-duplication at meiosis 1. Second process is maternal non-duplication at meiosis 1. And third one is maternal non-disjunction at meiosis 2. Now, the days with the help of hormone assay and karyotype analysis, scientists or doctors are able to find out male Klinefelter syndrome during men, and their life expectancy are almost similar to normal male. And they nowadays, due to invention of new technology, scientists are trying to give their lifestyles more complete manner. This is all about Klinefelter syndrome and their associated symptoms and their basic genetic background, how actually Klinefelter syndrome may produce. Thank you.